Ketika Ratu Case, Navigating Through Social and Economic Crisis, published by Richard Ife's School of Business. I am Aulia Wiryatmojo from MBA ITB, and I will be the first presenter of Mustika Ratu Case. This case originated from Indonesia, which is located in Southeastern Asia, northwest of Australia. It began when the Asian financial crisis occurred. Indonesia was one of the hardest hit, resulted in unpredictable prospects of Mustika Ratu. Mustika Ratu is a leading Indonesia manufacturer of cosmetics and traditional herbal supplements founded by Mrs. BRA Muriati Sudibyo. The company was incorporated in 1978. Following this, throughout the 1980s, the company expanded its line of traditional cosmetics and established itself as the uncontested market leader. The company's success supported by well-managed marketing strategy and extensive distribution company, and makes Mustika Ratu as a local success story and able to expand in surrounding countries such as Malaysia, Philippines, and Middle East. However, the financial crisis devastated the Indonesian economy. Unemployment and domestic bankruptcy increased significantly. These things lead to demand changes in Mustika Ratu. Like I mentioned earlier, financial crisis had resulted in unpredictable prospects of Mustika Ratu. Then this question will arise. Should Mustika Ratu focus its energy on its domestic market in order to protect their existing position? On the contrary, the crisis could also present opportunities. So, would it be the most opportune time for speeding international expansion? I will discuss it further on analysis, followed by conclusion and recommendation. The financial crisis brought the demand changes. Now, I will explain about demand forecast. Demand forecast used to estimate the expected demand over a specified future period. The formula to calculate demand forecast in domestic and international consists of several variables. First is price, or PX. Price is related to production cost. From the income statement, it is known that increase in cost of goods sold will also increase about 20% of price good product. And second is income, or I. From the weekly wage rate data, it's shown an increase 7.2% in income, but could meet the inflation of consumer good. When we correlate it with financial crisis, low-income consumer will be the ones that mostly impact. Third is consumer and market, or M. 80% of market share might decrease with the change of social-economical structure and disposable income. Fourth is substitution price, or PY. For the domestic product, substitution price will have no effect on consumer substitution price, because increase in price to cover production cost is inevitable to all product given the current condition. While for the international product, substitution price from country with no economic crisis condition might be a threat. Fifth is taste, or T. Consumer taste will change simultaneously with income changes. For international demand forecast formula, currency must add up. So 6 is currency, or CR. From the foreign exchange rates data, inflation has made Indonesian rupiah currency drop from around 2,800 rupiah in 1996 to around 10,000 rupiah in 1998. From the demand forecast explanation, there is a possibility that demand will decrease. Further analysis, conclusion, and recommendation will be delivered by the next presenter. Thank you for watching this video. Good day.